Morning, I'm Joy Reyes here in ANC. I just want to ask first the main objectives of the National Academy of Sports.
Hi, Migs. Good morning. And of course, thank you for having me in your program. I'm so delighted to share with you the a background of the National Academy of Sports. Of course, Migs, you know, our objectives are anchored from the Republic Act 11470, which this is an act that created and established the Academy. So our main objectives, of course, because we are mandated to provide a secondary education, implement a secondary education and also a sports training program in a world-class facility. So we will be providing a platform for academically competent and athletically talented Filipino youth to become responsible world-class, no? Kasi world-class, eh? World-class student athletes playing a vital role in nation building. And of course, since we are also mandated to provide world-class facilities, so these facilities should be at par with international standards. And because of this, there will be opportunities for our student athletes to compete internationally to enhance their athletic skills and abilities. And of course, we would also like to institutionalize an educational system that will implement quality and enhance education program integrated with the curriculum in sports. Siyempre, kung meron kaming objectives, meron talaga kaming goal, ano? Our main vision really is to be a forefront of global sports development and education, producing well-rounded student athletes equipped with the ability and passion to become a source of national pride.
A basic need for the youth is education. Yeah. And right. Free scholarship with benefits for the chosen. What shall the selection process be? How many will be chosen? And what will the student athlete itself, you know, benefit from the program?
Okay. Initially, because we are just starting MIGS, you know, initially we are targeting 120 to 150 students for grade 7. So ang sa ngayon, no, we will be accepting grade 7 only. So every year we will be accepting grade 7. So that's about 120 to 150 students per year. Okay? I mean each year we will be accepting 150 students. So the academy will be catering grade 7 to grade 12. So ibig sabihin that's from junior high to senior high. So in a span of 6 years, the academy will be occupied by 900 students. No, that's it. That's as an estimate. Of course, we would want them to have that number always. Kumbaga constant number yan. No. Okay. So with regards to the selection process, we designed an annual search mechanism. We called it the NACENT. NASCENT. Yep, I think I spelled that right. That means a national annual search for competent, exceptional, notable, and talented student athlete scholars. So we designed that so that this will help our future students to be admitted in the academy. So of course, kailangan natin, one is because in the law, dapat natural Filipino born ano sila, Filipino born youth from all sectors, meaning this includes indigenous peoples and persons with disabilities. Okay, for as long as they are currently enrolled in grade 6, but they should be a graduate of grade 6 to be admitted. So dapat graduate sila ng elementary school at the time of application. So another selection criteria would be they have to show evidence of potential in their particular sport, because you know, the National Academy of Sports will be able to gather the cream of the crop of our country. No, these are the best students. No, from Palarong Pambansa, but not limited to Palarong Pambansa. They will also be coming from Batang Pinoy, Philippine National Games, and even national sports association organized tournaments or international competitions. Basta kailangan grade 6 sila, graduate sila ng grade 6, and they should not be more than 14 years old. So basically those are the you know basic requirements in our selection process. But we will be announcing and announcing this soon, ano, Migs, kasi we also need a directive. We're just waiting for the directive from our beloved Secretary Liling Briones of the Department of Education. So once that will be out already, then the admission requirements, all the details will be announced, no, in our social media platform as well.
Right. In your vision of the NAS, National Academy of Sports, what is the ideal path or like flow chart? If I'm going to start as a grade 7 student, going all the way to senior high, going into college, going into a career, what is that path like going to be for someone who's going to start here?
Okay. Thank you for that question, Migs. Of course, our student athletes will be prepared for various exit points when they graduate from the program. They can be prepared to take a degree in a university, or either as an exchange student, or kung ano pa, no? Kung talagang they'll be fortunate to really perform well in school, then they can also be a scholar in a university. Of course, our student athletes will be prepared for life in general, Migs. We don't want to stop them from pursuing what they want. And that's why we, you know, our students will be prepared to be a coach. They can be prepared to be a trainer, a fitness instructor, or an employment in a fitness industry, but they can also venture in entrepreneurship. So it will really be preparing them for life. Para at least when they graduate from NAS, there's a life ahead of them. If they want to pursue in professional sport, of course they can be absorbed by our NSAs in the elite program. Pwede din yun, no? Kaya this will also, I think, be an advantage for our NSAs, because we will be molding these students in the NAS. And if they still want to pursue, and other NSAs will want to recruit them, of course, ito ay kumbaga ready right, to compete, you know, well trained na tong mga to. At the same time, not only that, they are may education, no? Meron silang background.
When we talk about international exposure, it's no doubt, Edie Joy, in the Philippines, the kids that get international exposure are the ones from schools, or maybe who wants to have resources and support, right? But now, as we focus on international exposure for these young athletes, especially that we're going to be the ones coming from provinces, indigenous communities, you know, when you look at that whole spectrum, do you think as a whole in the Philippines, are we getting enough international exposure? If yes, what have been when you know learning so far?
Yeah, thank you again, Migs, for that interesting question. Now, one of the goal of NAS is to address the need for consistent exposure of our national of our student athletes in the international arena, and of course we would allow our students to participate and compete with athletes from other countries that are in the same level or category as them, no? So we want to foster the development of their confidence level. Kasi, syempre, I'm sure yung iba, yung mga ito mga batang to, no? Our future student athletes, we want them to experience a good exposure in the international arena. And for a start, it can be a dual program, I mean, a dual invitation, ganun muna, no? Para just to build their confidence and make them feel how it is to compete internationally. And then from there on, we can progress through time and make, more competitions, organized events, and ask for our international counterparts as well. Syempre, very relevant yung magiging performance din ng mga bata. And also, exposure to competitions abroad is very essential for our student athletes to get experience. wherein their skills can be put to the test. Kaya nga, kailangan namin mabigyan sila ng, hindi naman sobrang gulatan, but at least we can give them an edge that they'll be able to compete internationally at the same time able to deliver, no, whatever performance they have to show, no. And of course, they will be competing against the best, no, all over the world. Kasi nga world class tayo, so we are targeting at qualifying in the world class competitions as well. Right. And this would also give the athletes a chance to improve their skills, their relationship. You know, hindi lang naman yun MIGS ang target namin. Ano, it's not about just performing the skills, able to compete, but also allowing them to be exposed to different cultures, to different culture. Kasi isa yun sa mga values na kailangan namin turuan sila sa eskwelahan, to appreciate a different culture. At the same time, magkaroon sila ng value, carrying the value, the Filipino values when they're competing abroad. So
yes, right.
This would really also give our athletes a chance to iron out their skills. Talagang matuto sila, they have to know how to at least malang analyze, no? Isa yun sa mga gusto din namin matutunan ng mga bata. They have to know how far they're going, be able to analyze also their performances. Kasi hindi lang sila sobrang dependent sa coach, but we want them to instill that value that they'll be able to educate also themselves. Ah, okay, this is how I'm gonna improve. This is the caliber of my opponent. So I want them to have that kind of integration also when they go back. You know, whether they win or lose, they'll right. be able to accept whatever results.
Yes, Ma'am Joy. Lastly, when we talk about projections in terms of time and the accomplishments mm-hmm. that come with it, what are your projections? And you know, how can this whole movement be sustainable for the years to come?
This is just our first year, and mag-uumpisa pa lang kami ng school year this year. So we have plans, no? But we'll see how it goes, because our goals are there. But we think it would be wise to focus and make this take off first and foremost, no? So kailangan muna namin mag-take off. Of course, ang projection namin, exposure to international competitions, hopefully kasi ang cycle ng Olympics is also six-year cycle. So hopefully by 6 years, maybe not an Olympian, but at least meron na kaming ma-produce na talaga nasa world championships or world competitions or world events, no? So at least magka-qualify sila doon, kasi lang naman ang target namin. And then if they will really win, and that is a bonus for us. So yun yung maging projections. Siyempre, since NAS is being considered as the home of the champions, no? So in 10 years time, sana meron na tayong a future Hidelin Diaz, or a future
Olympians.
Like, Vienna,
yes.
Yung mga Olympic hopefuls natin. I hope they will be one of the lineups, no, in the next 10 years. So yun naman ang mga projections natin, MIGS. Of course, with our programs, you know, yung kailangan talaga namin ma-sustain yung aming programs.
All right.
For us to fulfill our mission and our goal.
All right. So National Academy of Sports Executive Director Joy Reyes, thank you so much, ma'am, for joining us here in ANC, and good luck po for the NAS. Thank you.